Lord Grey proposes to inquire into the nature of the existing distress. These words are enough to make one despair of him and his measures. Just as if the distress was temporary and had now arisen from some special cause. One would as soon expect them to propose an inquiry into the cause of the dirt in London streets. 45 years ago, the labourers all brewed their own beer, and now none of them do it. That formerly they ate meat, cheese, and bread, and they now live almost wholly on potatoes. That the felons in the jails and hulks live better than the honest labouring people, and that these latter commit thefts and robbery in order to get into the jails. It is no temporary cause. It is no feeling of discontent that is at work. It is a deep sense of grievous wrongs. It is long-harboured resentment. What are we to say of that part of Lord Grey's speech in which he speaks of instigators? Can these men look at the facts? Can they see the millions of labourers everywhere rising up? Can they see them breaking threshing machines? Can they see them gathering together and demanding an increase of wages? Can they see all this? And can they believe that the fires do not proceed from the same persons? The fires are the work of the labourers. And why are they so reluctant to believe this? Because the labourers are the millions. And because if the millions be bent upon this work, who is to stop it? The truth is that for many years past, about 45 millions a year have been withheld from the working people of England. About 5 or 6 millions have been doled back to them in poor rates, and the 40 millions have gone to keep up the military academies, standing armies, pensions, to build new palaces, and to be expended in various other ways not at all necessary to the well-being of the nation. And what is to be the result of all this? Why, a violent destruction of the whole fabric of the government, or a timely, that is, an immediate and effective remedy. And there is no remedy but a radical reform of the Parliament.